Another man done gone. Another man done gone from the county farm. Another man done gone. I didn't know his name. I didn't know his name. I didn't know.
It began with the music. 18 years, thousands of miles, and 500 pages later, it is an award-winning book. A book reminding us that behind every song, there is a singer and a creative tradition. Inheritances that individuals rework and renew, the materials and talents that form the beautiful music all around us. In this remarkable book, writer and musician Stephen Wade celebrates 12 performers found on Library of Congress field recordings of the 1930s and 40s. Who were these artists? How did their music arise? Where has it traveled?
Sea lion woman, sea lion, she drank coffee, sea lion, she drank tea, sea lion, and again the lie, sea lion, way down yonder, sea lion. I'm the log, sea lion, and the rooster crowed, sea lion, and again the lie, sea lion. Sea lion woman, sea lion, she drank coffee, sea lion.
Ain't no grave can hold my body down when the pipe trumpet sound. I'll be getting up. Walking round, ain't no grave can hold my body down.
Well, Jesus died to save me and all of my sin.
No matter, glory to God, we're gonna meet him again.
I said the Rock Island line,
here's a mighty good road.
I said the Rock Island line,
here's a road to ride.
I said the Rock Island line,
here's a mighty good road.
If you want to ride, you gotta ride it like it's fine. Buy your ticket at the station on the Rock Island line.
Like the music itself, touched by its locales, these recordings took place across the country. From the rail yards of Arkansas to the prisons of Mississippi, from the streets of Nashville to the mountains of Virginia. In September 1941, one of those recording sessions took place outside Salem, Virginia, in the front room of this log house, to document a woman you've probably never heard of. But she was a remarkable, unremarkable woman named Texas Gladden, a housewife, a mother, an amateur poet, and one of the finest ballad singers of the 20th century.
The old man was a-peeping through the crack, and he saw the old devil come a-lugging her back, and the fi-di-diddle-i-day, diddle-i-diddle-i-day. And said the old man, we're bound for a curse, for she's damned to hell and she's 10 times worse. And the fi-di-diddle-i-day.
5 decades later, Stephen Wade came to this home, to this very room where Texas recorded. In researching his book, he spent many days talking with Texas Gladden's family, including her daughter, Wilma Jean. The ballad singer was born in 1895 and named Texas. Her sisters were named Kansas and Virginia. When she was 17, Texas Smith met James Gladden. After a 2-week courtship, they eloped, commencing a marriage that lasted more than 50 years. Over the last few years, Wilma Jean has lost her voice, but she has not lost her love for the old music she heard in this home. Nor was her mother the sole musician in the family. Among them, Wilma Jean's uncle, Texas Gladden's younger brother, the legendary multi-instrumentalist Hobart Smith. Today, Stephen Wade plays Leather Breeches for Wilma Jean in her kitchen. And he plays it on the banjo that Hobart Smith used for his last recordings.
Leather Breeches is dried green beans.
Yeah.
No, I know that. That's why I was asking if you strung them, that Leather Breeches, because that's the term I know. It's not about the pants. It's about the green beans, yeah. Leather Breeches full of stitches. Sally sewed the buttons on. Leather Breeches full of stitches. Sally sewed the buttons on. Why?
Stephen and Wilma Jean have formed a close bond built on the treasured memory of Texas Gladden. This is an old photo of Texas with her daughter, Wilma Jean.
You want to go bye-bye? You want Granny Ma to sing a whole heap of little horses?
Mm-hmm. And the voice is Texas from one of her final recordings.
Go to sleep, go to sleep. Go to sleep, little baby. When you wake, get some cake and ride them pretty little horses. Black and a bay, sorrel and a gray, whole heap of little horses. Black and a bay, sorrel and a gray, whole heap of little horses. Little old horse, little old cow, ambling around the old hay mow.
Sad and glad that I'm going to see her in the hereafter.
Hobart Smith died in 1965, Texas Gladden in 1966. We filmed these scenes in 2017, and Wilma Jean passed away in July of 2018. But the musical legacy of the Smith and Gladden families lives on, remembered in the imperishable spirals of these recordings, their personalities, their singing styles, and their cultural heritage. It's an endless story of artists amplifying tradition's gifts and exerting their own creativity in their homes, their communities, and across the nation. The many voices that make the beautiful music all around us.